Hi, Marx.
I'm Brigitte. How are you?
Marx, this is Red. Red, he's Marx. Henry wants Red to personally supervise our next shipment, so you'll follow orders from her. Anyway, we came here today to check on operations. How many sacks are there in the safe?
Over here.
Okay.
This way.
Red, would you do the honors? You haven't forgotten the code.
Remember, the code that Lorinda uses are the numbers of your birthday.
Uncle, here, have some. It's delicious.
Thank you, Kyla.
Father? What do you say if you come back with me to Manila?
There are no guarantees in Manila. Here in situ, I have a job.
Father, I'm sure that you'll be able to find a job there. You used to live there, right? I just feel restless that we're so far away from each other.
I'm just worried, son. You know what kind of life I lived in Manila.
Father, don't forget you're a changed man now.
This toy is really cool, ma'am. I'm sure that any kid who will receive this will be very happy.
Make it quick.
Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Nikos?
Aunt Brigitte, Aunt Brigitte.
Hi, Nikos, darling. Do you know what day it is?
Yes, isn't it? Today is our special
day. Yeah. And just like I promised you before, we will have a special day every year. So every year you get a special toy. And this right here is super special.
It's like having two birthdays on.
Yeah. Open it. I remember my son Alexis every time I see you. I wish you were able to know him, Nikos. I wish we were one family along with Alexis. But he was not given a chance to live because of that red butterfly.
Huh?
What's wrong, baby?
I have this already. Aunt Red bought it for me.
Well, I'll just get you another one, okay? I'll get you a new one.
Here you go. Thank you. Here.
Are you moving to Manila?
I think it would be best if Father and I would be together.
What if I go with you? Yeah, that's right. I'll go with you guys. I'll stay at my aunt's house. It's like a vacation. Right?
You'll come with us?
Yes.
What about your mother?
I am sure she'll let me go. I'll just tell her that. I ought to get used to Manila so I won't have a hard time when I study there next semester, right?
Ma'am,
what
sorry.
The heck took you
let
so
me
long?
Help you with that.
Leave me alone!
Is dead. It's so hard to believe that she's gone.
Everything's gonna be okay, Henry.
Who is she?
That's Red. She's my hairstylist. She wants to earn a little more cash. So I encouraged her to be a dancer. She's pretty, right? She's Boris's associate. You know what I mean. I like her. We can use her. She just needs proper training. You came into my life. I knew my world will be all right. All the pain will flow out of me. I know now I'll be happy. I want to share my life with you. Teach you all what's good and true. Then one day, the angels came and showed you heaven's gate. Sleep now, my baby. Sleep now, my baby. Sleep now. Sleep, my little baby.
Good night, Nikos.
Please kiss Mr. Koala, too.
Okay.
And also Mr. Kong Kong. And don't forget Mr. Fish.
Andre!
Mr. Fish, Aunt, we have to go to sleep now.
Okay, go to sleep now. Good night.
Really? Thank you very much,
Dad.
That's why I simply love this little tights and pieces. I love you very much.
Yes, I'm handsome.
Handsome? Oh, of course you're handsome, dear.
You really can't remember where you learned that?
Like I promised you, Gaspar. Just continue threatening Red Butterfly. Don't worry and don't get impatient. The day will come when you can finally avenge your sister, Lolita Abron.
Ma'am?
Mishka, you can't sleep too?
Yes. Do you need anything?
How many years have you been here?
A long time now, ma'am.
Do you have children?
What? No, I don't. I've already dedicated my life to serving this family.
Is it hard to love someone else's children?
Not really. I've witnessed these kids grow up, So they're like my own kids, too. Why do you ask, ma'am?
Nothing.
Huh?
Well, I'll go inside now. Honey.
Hey, buddy! What's up? I've been wondering how you're doing. Why didn't you call me earlier? So, how is your father?
He's okay, Jovan. We're going home now. I'll be bringing him with me. He just needs a little more rest before we travel. I'm sorry, Jovan. I've been meaning to call you sooner.
Nikos needs me, Henry.
Red.
Henry, please. Please. Come here. I need to check on Nikos.
There's a monster in my room. Andret! Helena! Katrina!
Argos.
Yes, sir?
Where is your friend Orbida?
He just went home to the province because his father is sick.
Tell him, if he's not in class tomorrow, he's dropped.
But sir, that's impossible.
Tell him!
Okay.
Are you really sure about this? You know, I'm having second thoughts now about letting you leave.
Come on, Mother. I will only be there for a short time. Besides, going there now is a good opportunity for me to, you know, to learn what it's like to live there. That would be very useful when I study there.
I know why you want to go there. I just hope you won't get hurt.
Mother, you really don't have to worry that much about me. And wait a minute, are you saying that I like Yuri? Him? Mm. Come on! We've been friends since we were wearing diapers. I can't fall in love with him.
Yuri, what's up?
Hi, Jess.
Hey, Bye. Man. Welcome Yo. Back.
Hey, guys. Hey. This is my father.
Wow, well, the great hey. Yuri has Hello, finally returned. Hello, and where have you been? Well, you Here can we get go. All your things She's now and leave this dormitory.
What?
That's right. I've warned you several times.
There is not a day
so I took new boarders in your place. Those who can pay the rent.
Father, I'm sorry about this.
Landlords are really like that. You can't blame them, though, because times are really hard.
Thank you so much for this, Bebang. This is really embarrassing.
Don't worry. As soon as we get some money, we'll pay rent immediately.
Oh. This was really a vacant room. We don't have any use for it except for storage, see? Well, I guess we'll leave the two of you for now, so you can get some rest. Come on, you too.
Aunt. Thank you so much again, Bebang.
No problem.
Son, I'll put this inside.
Okay, Uncle, wait. Good night.
Okay. Kyla. Thanks a lot for your help.
That's nothing. Go to sleep. You have to wake up early tomorrow.
Okay.
Night. Give me a kiss. Okay, go upstairs and brush your teeth.
Okay.
Nanny, please help him.
Yes, ma'am.
Morning, Bye, son. Dad. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning,
Hi,
Father.
By the way, I'm reminding you, next week is my cheerleading competition. That's a Friday at 3 o'clock. I'll be expecting you there.
Dear, I'm sorry, but I have an important appointment on that day. I might not make it.
Father, that's why I'm informing you ahead of time. Please,
And that's why I'm answering you ahead of time. I might not make it. I'm sorry, dear.
I can go and watch you.
Am I inviting you?
Helena.
Excuse me, Father. I'll go ahead.
Excuse me. Helena!
I'm sorry. I'll talk to her when I get home.
There's no need. She might think you're taking my side. I'll take care of it.
So when did you arrive?
And what happened last night?
What are you talking about?
Incredible, man.
There's something I need to tell you.
Everybody!
Hey, come on.
She was there? Why didn't you call me?
Speak of the devil.
He's here.
I am handing out the results of your midterm exams. Quiver in your seats if you must.
I am already quivering.
Because I don't have any good news for you.
Oh my God.
Oh, thank goodness.
Oh my God, I got a passing score. I passed. You? What did you get?
As usual, Mr. Urbina topped the exams.
Good for you.
He got the perfect score.
Wow.
All right. All right. First time for everything.
Right. How's it going, boy?
Hey, good going, man.
And so cute, too. Nice, Yuri.
What did you get? Mr. Yuri,
Mr. Urbina.
Yes, sir?
Did Miss Argos mention anything about a message from me?
Sir, sorry, but...
What did you get?
Hand me your paper. You're a bright young man, Mr. Urbina.
Thank you, sir.
Unfortunately, you're not part of my class anymore.
What? Sir?
Goodbye.
What? What's wrong? What's happening? Hey, what is this all about?
What are you doing?
What's happening?
What'll we do now, Yuri?
I don't know.
Boy, he sure is a nutcase if he'll drop you from his class. You're the only one who listens to him.
Thank you for your support.
I'm expecting payment from all this. Take me out for coffee later, okay? After my cheerleading practice.
Helena, you know I don't have money, right?
Yuri, coffee is just a figure of speech. You can treat me in many ways, even just a stick of fishball. That will do.
You? Fishball?
Five, six, seven, eight.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I should have been a cheerleader too, you know. I dance well, I have a very sexy body.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Watch it!
Oh my gosh!
Is she okay?
Oh my God!
Helena!
Ouch! What happened?
Somebody call
her! Helena! Helena!
It's
okay!
It's okay! It's okay!
Stand back! Give her some room!
Don't move her leg!
Are you okay?
Don't move her leg!
To the clinic!
I don't know.
Who do I need to call?
Ouch!
You're right. We're here.
I want you to take care of this. Tomorrow.
Hello?
Hello? Good afternoon. May I please speak with Mr. Argos?
Who's this, please?
My name's Yuri. I'm a friend of Helena.
Yes, Yuri. What can I do for you? Can I take a message?
It's Helena. She just had an accident.
What? Where? Okay, we're on our way. Helena met an accident.
What?
Let's go.
Hi, Father.
Honey, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Don't worry. I'll be fine. This is just a minor injury. Hi, baby.
Who's he?
That's Yuri.
Good afternoon.
Yuri, this is my father, my brother, and my sister.
And she's, Ingrid.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Argos.
Oh, no, she's not a relative. She's just, family friend.
Were you the one who brought Helena here?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much for
Yuri, I know you still have a lot of things to do. You can go ahead if you want to.
Okay, I do need to get going.
Thank you very much.
It was nothing, sir.
Thanks, Yuri.
I'll go ahead.
Okay, bye. I'll see you. Bye. Helena, is he your crush? Come on, tell
Shh.
Me.
Quiet, Petrina.
Father!
Hey, you're right on time. Have you eaten?
Good evening, Father.
Huh?
I haven't eaten yet. Wow!
I hope you don't mind sardines. It's not much, but...
What are you saying, Father? Sardines happens to be my favorite.
Really? Well then, let's eat.
Good evening! We knew you'd be having dinner, so...
Hey, let's eat!
We brought you something. Come on, join us. Here, taste it.
Come on.
Here. That's from Aunt Bebung's restaurant. She cooked it herself. It's really delicious.
Wow. It smells good.
Taste it.
Thank you, Kyla. Jamil. Here.
Smells really good.
Come on, join us. What are you waiting for?
Oh, we're already full. You go ahead.
Thanks again for the food. It's good.
You won't be discharged until we see the x-ray results. The doctor wants to make sure you don't have a fracture.
No, you just scared them.
You're really very harsh, my dear. Now, you be good. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Okay, come on, everybody. Let's go.
Maybe someone should stay to watch over
Bye,
Helena.
Helena.
I'll stay with her.
Goodbye.
Let Boris do it.
It's okay. I'll do it.
Okay. We better
Good
go.
Night.
Mwah.
Bye, Father.
Goodbye.
What? Dude? You're helping out in Mrs. Bebang's restaurant?
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Oh my. I pity Mrs. Bebang. She might finish off all your stocks. She eats like a horse.
You're so hardworking. You're studying and keeping two jobs at the same time. Don't you get tired?
I need to do it. Father?
Yes?
Are you okay in there?
Yeah, I can do this.
You're sure you don't need help, Father?
I'm sure, son.
You want me to peel some fruits for you?
No, thanks.
Are you comfortable?
I'm fine.
That friend of yours seems really nice. Have you known each other for long?
Just recently.
Maybe, sometime, you can invite him to have dinner at our house.
Well, he's really busy.
Well, how about,
You know, my head really hurts. I'm going to sleep.
Father?
Yeah.
Will that take long? Let's go to sleep.
Just a few more minutes, son. I'll just finish this. Son, tomorrow I'll start looking for a job again, okay?
Father, you've just been discharged from the hospital, and I'm still doing okay.
Son.
Father, I don't want you to tax yourself too much for me.
Yuri.
And another thing, my salary's enough for both of us.
Yuri, my son. Now that we're together again, I want you to focus your attention on your studies. Not on looking for money to pay the rent, or tuition fees, or whatever it is that you might need.
Father, I'm just really worried about you.
I think I raised you a whole lot better than I expected, Yuri. You've already forgotten who the father is between the two of us. Go on. Go to sleep.
After all these years, you're back. Who are you anyway?
The one in the pier?
Yes, Father. I don't understand. You know, I haven't dreamt of her in a long while.
Then?
I don't know why it suddenly came back again last night. There was this woman, and she was shouting. There was chaos. Then I couldn't breathe. It's like... I don't know.
Don't worry, son. All things happen for a reason. It's just a matter of time when the reason's revealed. Did you see some numbers floating in front of that mysterious woman while she was shouting at the pier?
What?
You never know. It could be a sign that we might win a lottery or something.
Sir Dimitri, I'm begging you. Maybe you can give me a second chance.
Did I not make myself clear, Mr. Orbita? You are not part of my class. That's final.
So, what do you think?
About what?
Well, we'll let Yuri take you to the hospital. So, you know, you two can have a moment together.
Well, thank you. I'm so touched. Thank you. I already suffered a sprain, and yet you guys still think about that bet.
Mm-hmm. I have a feeling you enjoyed it, though. It seems our little drama worked.
So you gotta get well.
Don't you
hey, girls,
care?
What's up?
Sir, is there any other way?
Well, you can file a motion for reconsideration. And then, wait for a white crow to perch by your window. And then ask that white crow to deliver your motion for reconsideration to me. Then, maybe then, you can go back to my class, Mr. Orbita.
Were you the guys who beat up Yuri?
Me? Of course not.
Oh, come on. Don't deny it. I knew it was you. I know you. Who do you think you are, Troy? Don't you ever pull that stunt again, okay? Be thankful that Yuri asked me not to report you guys to the administration.
Wait. What did you see in that unsophisticated guy?
Maybe everything I didn't see in you. Even if he's unsophisticated, he's 10 times better than you as a person. I have just realized that. Even if a person is rich and brought up in the city, they can still end up acting like monkeys. Now get out.
Wait.
Get out! Get out!
Bye.
Red, how's Elena?
She's fine. Henry?
Well, Brigida?
We've identified the suicide bomber. Her name is Lolita Abron. Does it ring a bell, Red? You seem to be very forgetful lately.
Well, Brigitte, 6 months is...
Not enough time for you to completely forget about the wife of a man you had killed.
Really?
Can I look at that?
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
Yahoo!
Hey! Yahoo!
Hi!
Come in, come on! Hey! What are you guys doing here?
For you.
Hi, Yuri. Thank you. Hey, what are you doing
here?
Wow. Doesn't your shift at work start after your class?
We had to see you.
Hey, Elena. Don't you think that you've been staying too long in this hospital? I mean, you just tripped, right?
Are you okay, Jovan? I did just trip, okay? I fell down and sprained my foot really bad, okay?
Give her a break.
And it's my dad, for your information, who wanted me to be confined here,
That's not right.
Mm-hmm. How are you? You feeling better?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm okay. Hey, how did it go with Dimitri?
I'm working on it. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, you know how that professor could be. He can just drive you really crazy.
Jovan.
It's true.
Be careful. He might hear
pictures.
Pictures. Hey, no, wait a minute. Wait. Let's not take pictures here anymore, please.
Just one, okay?
Oh, yeah, I mean, right. Two.
I just need to finish this roll of film.
And yeah, it looks cheap, so forget about it.
Guys, this is a historic moment. This is proof that Helena Argos is human. Yeah. And okay. She doesn't only trip in love.
Okay. Never mind.
Okay.
One, two, smile.
All right.
Okay. One more time.
Please.
Come on, okay. Let's have
please,
one more.
Elena.
Okay, just
what?
The two of them.
Please.
You two only.
One more.
Both of you.
You two only.
Put your arm
around.
Come on,
yeah,
put your arm
come on,
here.
Give me your hand. Put it here.
Yeah. All right.
Okay,
there.
Just the two of them.
That's good.
Smile.
Okay,
oh,
just
Jovan.
The two of them now. Come on.
Out of there. Come on, Jovan. Oh, Jovan, stop fooling around. Stay here.
Okay.
Jovan.
Closer. One.
Closer.
Okay. Closer.
Closer.
One, two.
Closer.
Red, have you forgotten your own target?
Ma'am, when did the result come in? The information did not reach me, not even through our police contacts.
Does it matter where this report came from? What's important is that it's here. I guess this case is solved, gentlemen. Red, one angry and deranged widowed woman attempted to kill you, and that's it.
I don't believe Lolita was working alone.
Let's not make an issue out of a molehill.
No. Boris has a point. We can't and we must not discount the possibility that Lolita is crazy. Or that she has co-conspirators.
or a master.
Don't tell me you don't notice. Dude, the way Helena looks at you. The way she acts and the way she talks. Dude, I know that you're not that dense not to notice it. Dude, buddy, listen to me. I think Helena really likes you.
Yes, finally.
You got me there. So you're not that dense after all. So you did know that Helena really likes you.
What?
Dude, buddy, don't tell me that. You've fallen for her too.
Jovan, what are you talking about? Come on.
You're in love.
Jovan, what I was saying was, finally, I found a vending machine because I've been really thirsty. What nonsense are you saying?
Mario.
Sir.
Are you sure this is it?
This was the address given to me. Lolita Abron probably lived here.
Let's go. I'll climb this fence.
Yes, sir.
Be extra careful, Gaspar. Boris's investigation should not lead to you.
You don't have to worry about anything, ma'am. You can count on me, ma'am. If you need me to do anything else...
Hello? Hello?
Sir Boris, that's you. I'm sorry. I didn't recognize you.
It's okay.
Kit. Hey. You got out of your cage again. Let me help you in. There you go. Soon, Lolita. Very soon.
Sir, the neighbors did say that they saw a man who lived with Lolita in her house. He moved out his things last week. They didn't get to know him very well. He really didn't get out much.
And?
They also say that he kind of went nuts after he found out Lolita died in the explosion.
Do we have a lead on who the mastermind is?
Sir, it was a clean job. We couldn't find any lead in the house. But I've got a pretty good feeling. Miss Red knows who the mastermind is.
Gaspar. My beloved brother. I've done what I've always wanted to do. And that is to kill Red. To avenge my husband's death. Please don't get mad at me for leaving you. We'll see each other again anyway. I just can't take this pain that I feel inside. I hated Red because she destroyed my life. I thought about it carefully, Gaspar. If I would go through with blowing up Red's cell in the best possible way, I'm willing to sacrifice my own life. To avenge my husband's death and to kill Red. Now I'm happy to be reunited with my husband. Now my soul is finally at peace with my husband, Marcello.
If I hadn't left Lilita, if I hadn't abandoned her, this wouldn't have happened. I sometimes think her death was my fault.
You don't have anything to do with Lilita's death. This is all Red's doing.